Hello again, everybody. Here's an easy spelling bee word, fun. How do you spell it? American Heartland Theater, from now through August 22nd, you can go to the 25th Annual Putnam County Spelling Bee. There it is, and it is an awful lot of fun, and we're going to talk now to Ken Remmert, and you play in this wonderful little trip back in time, for most of us, back to our young hood.
Spelling Bee
You
time.
Play what?
I am Vice Principal Doug Panch.
Doug Panch.
Doug Panch.
That's nice. Sounds right. Like something you should see a dermatologist for, but okay. Doctor, my Doug Panch has come back, and I'd like some ointment.
And Doug Panch is the guy who feeds the words to the spellers.
Really?
But now Doug Panch has come back after a little incident that happened 5 years ago at the 20th annual Putnam County
Spelling
Bee.
So he has a past.
He has a past. He has a story, but he doesn't really tell anybody about it. It's a mystery.
Is this assistant principal? And I love all assistant principals and principals. As long as my kids are still in school, I love them all.
Love them all.
But is this assistant principal? Is there any? Is there like a dark undertone? Sometimes they're the tough guy or the tough gal in the school.
There is a dark side to Doug Panch, and I'm not really sure he likes kids.
Good.
That's the problem.
It's a good choice for him.
Yeah. So he decided to go into education and became a vice principal.
Nice.
And so after the incident, he's back and spelling or feeding the spelling words to the kids.
Yeah. Are you a good speller yourself?
I'm not. I'm horrible. Got that from my father.
That's what Price said earlier. He's horrible, too.
Thanks a lot, Price.
Well, not that you were horrible.
Oh.
Not as a person, anyway. But, no, he felt that he was horrible. When you were a kid, did you participate? All of us did this, didn't we?
Well, I did, mostly because it was required in some of our classes. But I never went beyond grade school with spelling bees. I never had the opportunity, never the desire to do any spelling bees in middle school.
Do you remember any word that threw you? Was it that much of a memory for you?
We always had trouble. I do remember the word that always, it was whose.
Really?
Because we didn't know which whose it was.
So, which whose, you sound like Dr. Seuss.
That's right.
On acid all of a sudden.
Whose is what?
W-H-O-S-E, that whose?
That's what I thought.
Or could it be W-H-O apostrophe S?
That's what we thought too. We couldn't quite tell, but I got out on whose. And I can't remember which one it was that I got out on, but it wasn't the other one.
Because sometimes it seems like the simple, I mean, not for these spellers we see on ESPN, but sometimes, right. I know somebody, for example, for whom, very smart person, for whom garage completely did her in.
Yeah.
Garage.
I've heard that. That's right. She shared that with us also.
And that was a tough word.
It was a tough word. And it's surprising that sometimes the simplest words, you just go blank.
Is this, we were talking about this before we started, you bring people up from the audience.
We do.
And so that makes each night, no matter how well prepared and practiced and professional all of you fine actors at the American Heartland are.
Right.
Or you.
Thank you.
It makes every night different, doesn't it?
Very different and very exciting. It's interesting to see the rest of the cast. The energy level just goes up when the audience members come on stage because we have to be on our toes. We never know what's going to come out of their mouths, and we hope it's appropriate and they're spelling the words.
You play an assistant principal, which makes you sort of an authority figure here.
Yes.
Do you find that when, in the course of rehearsing and getting ready for this, do other characters like Price, who plays a 12-year-old boy, does he start to treat you with more deference and respect?
Actually, the whole cast really treats me with reverence.
Is that right?
True. Every one of them. And I think it's mostly because I'm the oldest one in the cast, and they think that I need more assistance.
Is that right? They help you up onto the stage?
Yeah.
Stuff like that.
Right.
Now, you were on this little show, our old-fashioned version, some time ago. You've been acting a lot in the Kansas City area for years.
Yes, been very fortunate.
What is it about acting in Kansas City that keeps a talented man like yourself here? Because you're working all the time, and what about this place makes it fun to work?
I think what makes it so nice is that there are so many opportunities for live theater.
Right.
We have a lot of live theater and a lot of live professional theater in town, which in my case, I've got a family in town. I'm not planning on going anywhere. I can pursue acting career or acting opportunities in town, and they are there.
Mm-hmm.
I think that what's so attractive about it is that there's just so much of it in such a small venue.
Right.
Compared to like a Chicago or a New York or a Los Angeles. For Kansas City, we've got a lot of live theater. It's unbelievable.
And you're quite active as well in your church with music and worship through music.
Right. I am a worship arts director at North Cross Methodist Church, and I'm the rock and roll guy, so I do the praise music at church on Sunday morning, and then I go to a show on Sunday afternoon.
What's the reaction? Let me ask you this, because when I go to church, and I'll admit it, I'm kind of a traditionalist.
Mm-hmm.
And when the church starts using drums and right. and amplifiers, it makes me nervous, because I grew up in a little town in Wisconsin, and you really didn't do that.
Right.
What's the reaction when you first spring something like that on a congregation, that, hey, this is a different way to praise God, but in a different way?
Well, the reaction is a little bit mixed, because some of them are like you, very traditional,
right.
and want to keep it that way, and there's a reverence that's involved, and I absolutely agree with that. But to me, the praise services are about a celebration. You know, it's about the party that we have at church, and it's about celebrating, you know, our faith and good stuff like that. And so there's some resistance to it, and what's nice about the church that I go to is that the resistance is really kind of quiet. They just would rather not tell you about
and
it.
And they have other options for worship.
We do. We have the regular traditional service, so, you know, you would probably come to our early service, because we have organs and choirs and robes and all
oh,
that
wow.
stuff, or you can come to the 11 o'clock service where we wear jeans and hit drums and
be scared to death.
That's right.
We're talking about the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee. You play the principal, Doug Panch. And what's the best
vice principal? They won't
I'm
let
sorry.
Me be principal.
The best time, the best, like, in 10 seconds, the best moment in the play for you is what?
The best moment in the play?
Like, you look forward to it every night or every matinee. This is the one I want to do.
Oh, the moment? Oh, man, now you're really...
See?
There's a lot of great moments in this. I really love the pandemonium time, the pandemonium song.
Oh, good.
Because it's craziness on stage. And we have the audience members involved in the craziness. They kind of get swept up by the rest of the cast being pulled around on stage. And
excellent.
But I don't want this to scare you from coming
no,
on.
No, but it
because
might anyway.
You're going to be coming on stage with
well,
us.
Well, we'll
spelling,
see.
Right?
That's the rumor.
That's great. So I just want you to know, are you going to really commit to us right now that you'll be on stage?
Wow.
Committing to us?
We'll be back. Here's the phone number, by the way, 816-842-9999. Ken Remmert from the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee on stage at the American Heartland Theater. Go be a part of it. Wait for the pandemonium scene. And who knows, you may see me. You may see other people from Channel 9 showing up there. Thanks, Ken, so much.
Thank you.